But the latest, perhaps really, next to Mexico and the Jazz High, I'll tell in a minute. Best Vision, also on High, but under entirely different circumstances, was the vision I had of Neil as he showed me one afternoon in January on the sidewalks of Workaday San Francisco, just like Workaday Afternoon on Moody Street in Lowell, when boyhood buddy funny guy G.J. and I played zombie piggybacks in mill employment offices and workmen's saloons. Silver Star it was. And what and how the Three Stooges are like when they go staggering and knocking one another down the street. Moe, Curly, who's actually the bald-domed one, Big Husky. And Meaningless Goof, though somewhat mysterious as though he was a saint in disguise, can't remember his name, a masquerading super-duper witch doctor with good intentions, actually. Can't think of his name. Neil knows his name, the bushy, feathery-haired one. Neil was supposed to be looking after his work. We just blasted a pint in the car. We drove down the hill into wild mid-market traffic and out Third past Little Harlem, where 2.5 years ago we jumped with the Wild Tenor Cats and Freddie and the rest. But now it's May, and they're going to a show and saying good evening to the bums who sit in state over this old thing, just like French sewing sisters in a provincial town. May, and Larimer Street is hum buzzing with that same excitement, that same countrified, wrangly, sad toot and tinkle of old mainland shopping streets in Charleston, West Virginia, with all its spotted farmer cars ranged and the canola flowing. In the southern railroad town, the boils of activity are sun-tortured 5 and 10s, across from the tracks, awnings, nations of Negroes lounging by beater stores and near the tobacco warehouses, flashing aluminum lights in the southern day fire. In the southern railroad town, the moils of activity are sun-tortured 5 and 10s, across from the tracks, awnings. Nations of Negroes lounging by beater stores and near the tobacco warehouses, flashing aluminum lights in the southern day fire. Los Angeles, when the parade goes up and down both sides, cracked old crazy John Gaunt from a rackety house in a telegraph grove outside the Bakersfield Flats, with his entire brood of 9 packed and pushed up to the torn flat-bass black top fallen roof of his fantastic ancient 1929 touring Imperial Buick with the wooden spokes, 2 of them cracked, in a side rack for spares like a snail's shell goof on the running board. gone, gaunt, and Ma gaunt, with her overalls in sorrow. Has to wait while Pa gets his fill at the shooting gallery at South Main, two blocks from Systemata Parks. So when Neil dreamed of being Christo thrown in the sea in a bag, I was kidnapped in Shanghai and orphaned to strange but friendly old Chinaman, who was my only contact with hopes of returning to my former life. Orphaned in the interesting old void, eh? Third Street and all that. We came driving slowly, noticing everything, talking everything, at the rail yards where we worked, and got out of the car to cross the warm, airy plazas of the day, and there particularly with a fine soot scent of coal and tide and oil and big works. A fly across haze oil shimmers, tar soft on the shoe. Noticing how great the day and how in the experience of our lives together we're always finding ourselves in the golden, sleepy good afternoon, just like fishing. Really like the afternoons that must have been experienced by the noble son of his host, Nestor's friend. Wild night charioteerings across the ghosts and white horses, a phallic classical fate in the gray plain to the sea. Tired winners, caresses of cups and figs and the lull of heroes, just like that. Admit that we're high and that was real good wine and more instant and interesting and always happening and everything always all right. Sauntered thus. Come in the green clunker for some reason. Wore our usual greasy bum clothes. Put real bums to shame. But nobody with the power to reprimand and arrest us in his house. Began somehow talking about the Three Stooges. We headed to see Mr. So-and-so in the office and on business and around us. Conductors, executives, commuters, consumers, rush stores, sometimes just maybe ambling Russian spies carrying bombs in briefcases. And sometimes rag bags, I bet. Just foolishness. Nothing but whiteness and everything busy, official, let's say Californian, no spitting. You're at the carbon arches of a great white temple of commercial travel in America. If you're going to blank your cigar, do it on the sly. And so on. But really, when it came into Neil's head to imitate the stagger of the Stooges, and he did it wild, crazy, yelling in the sidewalk right there by the arches and by hurrying executives, I had a vision of him which at first, manifold it is, was swamped by the idea that this was one hell of a wild, unexpected twist in my suppositions about how he might now in his later years feel, 25, about his employers and their temple conventions. I saw his, again, rosy, flushing face exuding heat and joy, his eyes popping in the hard exercise of staggering, his whole frame of clothes capped by those terrible pants with 6-7 holes in them, and streaked with baby food, ice cream, gasoline, ashes. I saw his whole life. I saw all the movies we'd ever been in. I saw, for some reason, he and his father on Merrimack Street not carrying me. Their Sunday afternoon walks, hand in hand in back of great baking soda factories, and along deadhead tracks and ramps, at the foot of that mighty red brick chimney, La Chirico or Chico Velasquez, throwing a huge long shadow across their path in the gravel and the flat.